No, everyone wants to bring the cup back home, so the team is so motivated, and I really believe we're ready to do it for South Africa. And the atmosphere is also now positive, and a sense of desire and want to really go and show the world and South Africa that we want to do it for our country.
काफी टैलेंटेड है आपकी बेटी
सर, बड़ी होकर इंडिया के लिए खेलना चाहती है। उसके फ्यूचर के लिए अभी से मैंने सेविंग भी स्टार्ट कर दी है।
फ्यूचर की बात है तो सिर्फ उसे नहीं, आपको भी मैदान में उतरना पड़ेगा।
मुझे इनका मतलब है म्यूचुअल फंड्स के मैदान में। सिर्फ सेविंग्स नहीं, हर महीने म्यूचुअल फंड्स में भी इन्वेस्ट कीजिए,
वरना आपकी बेटी तो बड़ी होगी
पर उसके लिए सेव किए हुए पैसे शायद उतने ही रह जाएंगे।
सही है सर।
म्यूचुअल फंड निवेश बाजार जोखिमों के अधीन है। योजना से जुड़े सभी दस्तावेजों को ध्यान से पढ़ें।
I was very shocked. I was so surprised, and it's almost, it's maybe still a bit unbelievable. I think it hasn't really sunk in. But I was excited and of course a bit nervous at the same time. But it felt like actually unreal. Yeah, that was also incredible. I mean, it was such an honor just to be able to get selected and represent your country. It's an unreal feeling. You can almost can't describe it. Of course, my preparation. So I make sure to all the time I get possible any chance I get to train, but I train and use maximize my training time, and also be specific in it, and then the basics of making sure my conditioning, my gym and my running also is on standard. So we work closely with our S&C and with the coaches to, because you won't get the game time, so you have to almost make up for that hour and a half of fielding and 4 hours of bowling and batting, or how it works out. So I just make sure to keep on training as much as possible and staying up to standard, not getting beyond. That's true. Cricket is so mental. The main things for me is I have a few objectives or goals I want to reach in a session. So I'll be specific on maybe two or three, and if I can tick that boxes, I'm happy. And then especially with batting, having clear game plans. So I like to write a lot and just analyze, and yes, after and before sessions, to be specific in what I go train, as if you are preparing for a match. I hope that's clear enough.
Yeah.
I would definitely say more of a bowling all-rounder currently. So just to be able to, when you get the ball in hand, to bowl as much dots and singles, and so that will be my, bowling will be my main focus. And then I think as a traveling reserve, I just want to help the team also prepare as well, so to bowl to them in the nets. And it's still a question I can maybe answer a bit later better. But for now, my main focus will be bowling. At least I have my good friend here, Seshni Naidu, who's also a year younger than me. But we are very close to each other. So at least we two, we almost like we go together. We do the things together. But being the youngest, I think it almost gives me the right to ask questions and really want to learn from all the players. But I would definitely say the team still thinks I'm very shy and introvert. So hopefully I can be start being more comfortable as the tour goes along. I'm still a bit starstruck, I think, by everyone. But being the youngest isn't that bad. I like the opportunity to learn and grow. So I take that. I believe in playing matches is one of the most important ways you can get better. So domestic cricket, it provides you the opportunity to play 50 over and T20 cricket against the the rest of the best players in the country. And you get in situations where you are under pressure, and it's not close to international cricket, but you still get under pressure. So yes, I think domestic cricket provides you the opportunity to play against the best in the country, and just getting that game time to develop your game, batting, bowling and fielding. Yeah, sharing a dressing room with Miane Smit, that's amazing. It seems so unreal. And she's really so experienced, and I think what makes her such a great team player is that she's not scared to share knowledge. She wants to help, and she will somehow come out of herself and give you advice and share some of her knowledge and wisdom. So I really enjoy it. When I have questions, I go to her. And she's really approachable and amazing person to do, to play cricket with, even on the field. She fields a point, and I sometimes feel that cover, and she will say, okay, but look at this, look how the batsman is standing. I think we must change this angle. It's a real honor, and it's very great. I want to be a World Cup winning player for South Africa. I want to be an impact player who scores 50s and 100s and takes wickets. Currently that's what I'm working towards, a World Cup winner player for the Proteas. Under-19 cricket is almost, it helps you to make the next step from domestic cricket and provincial cricket to get your bit of international experience, although it is at an under-19 level. So it puts you in a space where you have to you play against different countries with different styles of play, so you have a bit of a different point of the research and the prep you do. So you have to be specific in the different players. So it's that almost preparing you to go into a women's international space. It was a good experience playing under-19 cricket, and has helped a lot to shape how you are preparing for women's international cricket. I remember we batted first that match, and the batting didn't go well, and I was not encouraged to go play now and go field and bowl, so I was a bit down. And when we went onto the field to go bowl, and I just focused on what I had to do, and the wicket just came and came and came and came. So that was one of the most memorable games in my career so far. It was amazing. It was very good, Yes, the whole World Cup was a challenging experience and a challenging period. The team, we came out of a difficult place, losing all our warm-up matches against India in our series, and then also the warm-up matches that didn't go well. And the first match came against India, and we all were a bit unsure of how this World Cup is going to play out. And even though we lost the first match against India, there was hope. I mean, Simone Lawrence played an amazing innings there, and from that match on, the team just started believing that we can actually do this. And we won all the rest of the group matches, and we made it through to the Super 6 rounds, where we played, it was Bangladesh, in a very tight game, but we got over the line there, and also Sri Lanka in our last match, which was also a one-run win. So we were very discouraged sad and disappointed when we didn't make the semi-finals, but we know we gave it our all in that World Cup, and it was just a bit unlucky to get into the semi-finals. But overall, the experience was difficult, but it was so great doing it with a high note, only losing one match in the whole World Cup. campaign. It's an interesting story. So I'm blessed to have two younger brothers, and growing up we lived in the same yard almost as my nephews, which I had four of. So since a young age, we just played sport in the backyard, rugby and soccer and cricket. And my dad was kind enough, or he encouraged me to play with him when it came to cricket. So since a young age, I just played with the boys and with my family in the backyard. And then when I went to school in grade one, my dad, without my mom knowing, went to the cricket coach and asked, can she play with the boys? And he's like, yes, sure. So my mom didn't know at first that I was playing cricket with the boys, because she wouldn't have allowed her girl to play cricket. But the first match came and my dad had to tell my mom, you know, Miane is playing cricket. So we just started in the backyard with my brothers and nephews. And then I just started playing with the boys in primary school, till high school, where I was introduced to women's cricket, which I actually didn't even know existed growing up. So that's the short story. I'm actually currently trying to study accounting. So that's definitely something, if cricket maybe doesn't work out or later in my career, is definitely a career option I am thinking about, being an accountant. When I was very little, always AB de Villiers. Just the way he plays cricket and the team player he is. My first cricket bat was also a Kookaburra bat. But when I got introduced into women's cricket, it was without a doubt Laura Wolfart. I think she's an amazing player, so hardworking and resilient. And even now, being in a team with her, I just look what she does and I take notice of it, and I can see, okay, she goes for extra skills or extra catches, and always does the extra, even though she's already a world-class player. So it's definitely Laura Wolfart, but I can say almost every player on the team I'm currently with, Kapi and Sunay and Nadine, all just brilliant players.